We're going to study about a small and a simple topic again, that is mechanism of gender determination, or what you commonly call it as mechanism of sex determination. See beta, the establishment of sex or establishment of gender through differential development in an individual at the time of zygote formation is what we call as sex determination. It seems to be a little complicated definition, but it is not. Look for the keywords. What are the keywords over here? Differential development, number one, and second is zygote formation. Just remember these two keywords. First is differential development. What is taking place is differential development. And when is it taking place? It is taking place at the time of zygote formation. Now, very simple. Establishment of sex through differential development in an individual at the time of zygote formation is what we call as sex determination. There was a scientist, botanist, Henking. His name was Henking. In 1891, he did a wonderful, interesting experiment. 1891, Henking. He traced a specific structure. He did not know what the structure is, but he was observing the process of spermatogenesis. And he found something very interesting, that there was a structure. He kept on observing it throughout the process of spermatogenesis in few insects. He took a variety of insects, and he observed spermatogenesis in all these insects. He found he could trace out a specific structure which was seen all through the process of spermatogenesis in these insects. To his amusement, he found that 50% of the sperms received this specific structure after spermatogenesis. So after this structure was present through the entire process of spermatogenesis, and at the end of spermatogenesis, he observed that 50% of the sperms received this structure and the other 50% did not receive it. Clear? What did he observe? That 50% of these sperms, after the process of spermatogenesis was over, he concluded and he found that 50% of them received the structure, 50% did not receive it. He did not know what the structure is. Because normally in maths what we do, any unknown thing we take it as a variable as x. He did exactly the same thing. He named this structure as X-body. What did he call it as? X-body. Later, scientists concluded that this X-body was a chromosome and called it as the X-chromosome. What is it called as? X-chromosome. So what about Henking's experiment and observation? Very simple. In 1891, he observed spermatogenesis in few insects. And he observed that through the entire process of spermatogenesis, there was a specific structure which was observed. However, at the end of the spermatogenesis, 50% of the sperms received the specific structure and 50% did not receive it. Since he was not aware about this structure, he simply named it as an X body. Later, the scientists concluded that this X body was a chromosome and they called it as an X chromosome. Then we came up with the chromosomal theory of sex determination. This was proposed by E.V. Wilson and Stevens. Okay, now we are talking about the chromosomal theory of sex determination. This was proposed by E.B. Wilson and Stevens, 1902 to 1905. Wilson and Stevens. What did they do? They named the XY chromosomes as allosomes. Okay, the sex chromosomes X and Y, they called them as allosomes. A-L-L-O-S-O-M-E-S, allosomes or sex chromosomes. And all the other chromosomes, which had no relation with the sex determination, they called them as autosomes. What did they do? They made two categories of all the chromosomes, autosomes and allosomes. Autosomes, all the chromosomes, the other set of chromosomes, the entire set of chromosomes, which are not involved in sex determination, they called them as autosomes. And the XY chromosomes, which were responsible for sex determination, they called them as allosomes. What were they called? Allosomes. So they broadly classified the chromosomes into two categories, allosomes and autosomes. On the basis of allosomes, that means on the basis of X and the Y type present in the gamete, parents can be of two types. They can be homogametic or they can be heterogametic. Homogametic, that means producing similar gametes, or heterogametic means producing different gametes. When we use the word homogametic, that means the parent is producing similar gametes. And when we say the parent is heterogametic, it means the parent is producing different gametes. There are various sex determination mechanisms which are observed in organisms. Mainly two concepts we have in our syllabus. First is the male heterogamety and What is male heterogamety? Heterogamy is different. Gametes, you know, heterogamy is different and gamete is gametes. And male, that means it is found in males. So mechanism in which male produces two different types of gametes is known as male heterogamety. Very simple. Heterogamety means different gametes. I use the word male. Male heterogamety, it means the mechanism in which males will produce two different types of gametes. Similarly, we have female heterogamety. What happens in this? In certain organism, it is a female which produces two different types of gametes. So that concept or that mechanism is called as female heterogamety. I would also like to take up a very interesting small topic, that is sex determination in honeybee. Okay? In insects like honeybee and ants, the sex chromosomes are not differentiated. Is it okay? There is no differentiation as such, very clear XY chromosomes and all. So sex is determined on the basis of ploidy of the individual. Ploidy, P-L-O-I-D-Y, whether they are haploid or they are diploid. Okay? It's interesting. Here, what is there in honeybees and ants? Here we do not have any differentiation of sex chromosomes. We do not have any chromosomes which are differentiated for sex determination. So the gender or the sex of a honeybee or an ant is determined or based on the ploidy, P-L-O-I-D-Y, ploidy. That means whether they are haploid or they are diploid. In honeybees, drones are males. We know the males are actually drones and they are haploid. N is equal to 16 there. Okay? Males are haploid, N is equal to 16. And these drones, that is these males who are haploid, develop from unfertilized eggs of females. They develop from what? Unfertilized eggs of females. This concept is also known as sometimes in biology as ahenotoky. A-R-R-H-E-N-O-T-O-K-Y. Okay? A-R-R-H-E-N-O-T-O-K-Y, ahenotoky. What is this ahenotoky? Where the haploid males develop from unfertilized eggs of females. Because the female egg is not getting fertilized, so the offsprings are males but they are haploid. This is ahenotoky. They produce haploid gametes by mitosis like division. What will they do? They will also produce haploid gametes. The drones, that is the males, they will again produce haploid gametes by mitosis kind of a division. However, the females, they are diploid. As I told you, the drones, males are haploid, N is equal to 16. And when I say the females are diploid, that means 2N is equal to 32. When we talk about the female honeybees, we are talking about the queen and the worker bees. Okay? And they develop from the fertilized eggs. Got the main difference now? The drones, that is the males, they develop from unfertilized eggs of females. And they are haploid. The queen and the worker bees, they are females, they develop from fertilized egg. And they are diploid. In terms of sex determination, this method is also known as haploid-diploid method. What is it called as? Haploid-diploid method. Where the haploids are males and the diploid are females. So this is all about sex determination in honeybee. Thank you.